Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Swag for today's episode has been brought to us in part by Woodcraft, helping you make wood work, and by Whiteside router bits made in the USA. Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop podcast. All right, so it's the beginning of a brand new year, and we've got a lot planned for this brand new year of 2009. And we're going to make a few changes at Matt's Basement Workshop, but I swear they're only going to be for the good. And you probably already noticed a couple of them. Number one, we have a brand new website. Now, it's still a little bit in the construction phase, so there's a little bit of a lap over. But you know what? We're going to talk about that in a completely other episode, because with it being the first episode of a brand new year, and it's the first episode of a brand new month, that can mean only one thing. And we really need to jump right into this, because it's time for Roundover! That's right. Once again, the great folks over at Woodcraft and Whiteside Machine Company totally set us up, and they sent us another great router bit to try out here in the basement workshop. But of course, more importantly for one of you, well, at the end of today's episode, we're going to find out who the lucky winner is of this great router bit. So what do we have? Well, before I talk any more about this, I want to remind everybody, of course, that every single month, Woodcraft picks one of the many, many great profiles that Whiteside Machine Company makes, and they put it on sale all month long. In fact, they take about 25% off the regular price and make it just that much easier for us to head on over to our local neighborhood Woodcraft store, if you're lucky enough to have one nearby, or you can easily head online. Of course, I will make sure to have links in the show notes so that you can head over to woodcraft.com and pick up one of these great router bits for yourself if you're not today's lucky winner. And more or less, it just makes that much easier for it to add to our collection. Of course, we're building up a huge collection of Whiteside router bits. I mean, they just work fantastic. So anyways, though, what do we have? Well, for the entire month of January 2009, let me get this out here. Whiteside Machine Company's 1/8-inch Roundover bit is the router bit of the month here at Matt's Basement Workshop and also at woodcraft.com. Now, this is a great little bit. Of course, it's just a basic Roundover bit, so there's not really too much more we can add to it, because a lot of us, we're already familiar with a Roundover bit. But we'll talk about a couple ideas that we can use this for, because this actually has a really great purpose that we should have in our shop for making very uniform Roundover cuts. But we'll talk about that in just one second. Right now, let's go ahead and get a little bit closer look, and let's talk about the actual, well, the dimensions, the specs, and everything we want to know about this great router bit. And like I said, let's come in a little bit closer, and let's take a little bit better look at this other than holding it way back here. All right, that's a lot better. Now, if we take a little bit closer look at this, the overall size of the 1/8-inch Roundover router bit from Whiteside, it's just over 2 inches. In fact, it actually comes in at about 2 1/8 inches. And of course, you can see right down here, this is a little bit unusual for what we typically have here at the show, but this is a 1/4-inch shanked router bit. And I'm gonna explain one of the great things about that in just a second here. So we have about 2 1/8 inches in total length. He has two cutters on it, and of course, each of these cutters come in at about 1/2 inch in total length. So as you can see, this is a very tiny router bit when it comes down to it, but it's gonna do a lot of work for you. Now, of course, let's kind of turn this around a little bit. As we have come to expect from Whiteside Machine Company, that is a nice thick piece of carbide on there. So number one, with it being carbide tipped, we know that it's gonna be a long time before we need to worry about sharpening these babies. We're gonna get a lot of linear feet of round over with this, but considering that it is a Whiteside Machine Company bit, I mean, take a look at that. You're gonna get a lot of sharpenings out of this. So this bit is gonna last you for quite a long time. Now, another thing to point out is the overall diameter of the bit is about 3/4 inch. So again, very small, and you're gonna easily use this freehand. You can load it up into your router bit or into your router table if you want to, depending on the size of the component you're working with. It might actually be a little bit easier. And of course, one thing I have to mention, it's right here on top. We all know how much I love these babies. This is one of those famous Whiteside Machine Company bearings. I mean, I love these. You can cake them up with sawdust. You can just heat them up because you're using them on linear feet after linear feet of material. You can abuse them, but you know what? They just keep spinning like they're on butter. I love these bearings. They're just, I can't say enough about them. But anyways, though, of course, as part of the profile, and we'll just kind of turn it just a little bit here so we can get a better look at it, you can see that little 1/8-inch roundover. I mean, it's really, really tiny, and that's what's going to be doing all the work for us. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to zoom back out, and I want to talk a little bit more about actually using the 1/8-inch roundover bit, because like I said, it's just a simple roundover bit, but you know what? There's something that this bit does way better than any other roundover bit, so let's talk about that next. Okay, when it comes down to it, really, a roundover bit is a Roundover bit is a Roundover bit. One thing that they do extremely well is, of course, they help to break down the surface so that we get that nice little convex shape on there. But more or less, it gives us a really beautiful edge detail, because sometimes, you know what, you want nothing more than just a simple little Roundover. And the nice thing is, one of the reasons why we like to have Roundovers on our edges is because it really helps to, like, just the light breaks just right on it. A nice square edge just looks too, well, it looks too square, number one. But more importantly, the light just won't dance off of it the right way. It does not look good. Try it, you'll see exactly what I mean. They will look completely different, and it's not just because of the Roundover. Now, another important thing about having a Roundover bit is the fact that if you did have a nice square edge, the problem is if you were to bump into it, it hurts. There's no getting around. I don't care how big and tough you are. A nice square edge really, really hurts. And so having that Roundover on it helps to kind of take that owie out of it. But more importantly, when you hit a nice square edge, another thing that can happen is that not only will it hurt you, but it can splinter the edge itself. It's very, very easy to break off little tiny pieces. I have happened on my furniture all the time on areas where I just left a nice square piece. I didn't round it over or make any other type of edge profile to it. So that's one of the importance of having a good Roundover. Now, of course, Roundovers come in all sorts of different sizes. Of course, this is our 1/8-inch Roundover for this month. And this is one that we've had previously. This is a nice about, I'm going to say it's about 1/4 to 3/8 inch. I should be more familiar with my bits, but that, you know, we have that one. And then you can go to something as extreme as this one right here. And Whiteside, please forgive me for bringing somebody else into the video, but we have this one right here. This is an old one, and I've had it around for a long time. And that's about 1/2 inch in total width. So you can kind of see, if we hold all three of these up there, and I'm trying to zoom in a little bit, we've got three very unique sizes, but they all do the same exact thing. They give you that nice round over, and it works in all sorts of different situations. Now, of course, as we said, you know, Roundovers are Roundovers are Roundover. And why do we need to have like a 1/8-inch one? Well, the best thing about this one right here is that Roundover is so tiny. If you're working with material, say you're building something like a shaker piece of furniture, and you still want kind of that square look to it, but at the same time, for all those reasons I just mentioned, you don't want a splinter, you don't want the owies or anything, you want that little bit of Roundover in there, this is the one for you. Because when you actually use this, and we'll demonstrate this in just 1 second, that little 1/8-inch Roundover makes it very, very subtle. In fact, actually, you get a similar cut using sandpaper. How many times have you been finishing a piece and then you'll just sand down the edges, because most of us will do that. Or one thing I like to do is I like to take my hand plane and I'll actually roll the edge. We've seen that one before. But one problem when you're sanding, or if you're doing it by a hand plane, is the fact that you don't always get a consistent edge all the way around. And that's one thing a lot of times, depending on what piece we're working for, maybe we want it to be a little bit more formal, we want that consistent edge all the way along the length. Maybe even another great application for this is, are you a toy builder? Are you going to make something for either your own child, or if maybe your grandchild, or maybe, you know, for one of the charities that you're working for? And of course, we want to break those edges because of the owies, because of the splintering and everything else. This is the one for you. It's going to take it off just enough, makes quick work of it, and you get an excellent result in the end. So let's go ahead and actually, we're going to chuck this up in a router, and we're going to take a little bit look at it and see the type of result we get from it. Okay, so we've moved over to the workbench a little bit, and I just want to kind of show you a few things. Typically, when I'm using the 1/8-inch Roundover bit, like I said, the main thing is I just want to break that edge. I want to take the owies out of there, just give it that little slight Roundover, but yet still give it that square look to it. You know what I mean? It's a nice little trade-off. And a lot of times, like I said, I might use this a lot if I'm working with, like, say, small projects or making toys or something like that, because the overall dimension compared to the size, this is going to look a lot more proportional than if I was using like either that 1/4-inch or the 1/2-inch one. A small project like this would just be completely lost if you were to use anything larger than this. Of course, you know what, if you choose to, that's perfectly fine, because it works for your project and that's all that's important. Now, of course, when using a tiny little bit like this, like I said, this one's really easy to use freehand, and typically, of course, the majority of us are going to turn to our router. And if you have a big monster router like this, well, then obviously this little baby is going to kind of get lost in the middle of it. And on top of it, if you were to be routing on a small project like this, I think we're all familiar with the fact that, you know, it's probably going to kind of lose, you know, a little bit of the base there. It's going to be a little wobbly and everything. So a lot of times what you can do is you can turn to like an auxiliary bass, and I actually happen to have one. I'll talk a little bit more about this because I think we want to get a little bit more into accessories, and I have what's called an offset bass, and this thing works really great. Basically, when I put it on, what ends up happening is it increases the surface area, obviously, but it gives me more balance because I can really kind of control this. And we'll talk about this in another episode where we'll either make a homemade one or I'll show you some other possibilities of things you can use. But if you're worried about having, you know, less control about it, another thing you can do rather than using your monster router is you can turn to something like this baby over here. Now, I actually borrowed this from a friend, and it's a obviously, it's a small laminate trimmer, and you can see how this one would be extremely beneficial. It's almost like with a small router bit, you've got a proportionally small router, and this one will definitely fit on top of the surface here. In fact, let's use the monster more as a base, and you can see how it'd be a lot easier to control the cut as it's going around. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to chuck the bit up into this, and we'll actually round this over to give you an idea of how things will work with it. But you know what? This thing looks so new. I'm not even sure that he's ever used this thing. Maybe I'll have to strike a deal with him. So let's do that next. Let's go ahead and chuck this up, and we'll actually round this over, and you'll get a great idea of how this baby works, and we'll see the end result. Okay, so we've got our bit all chucked up. It's plugged in, and we've got our little piece. Now, when we're going to route, anytime we're working on the outside of a piece, we're going to go counterclockwise, and then if this had a cutout on the inside, we would then go actually clockwise. So let's go ahead and, it's kind of nervous because I've never used one of these before, and it's so light, I'm afraid I'm not going to have enough control. But let's see what we get here. Let's go ahead and start it up. All right. Pass. I know I went back and forth there, probably not the best idea, but you know what? Wow, that worked really great. And there's our edge. I mean, look at that. It's just a slight one. I probably could have backed it off just a little bit, but still, that looks fantastic. Wow, that actually took that little scrap piece and I turned it into something nice. All right, so as you can see, it definitely gave a beautiful, beautiful edge to it. And we'll try and get that in there. I'll get some stills up. You'll see it in the show notes. But basically, I had it pretty much at full depth, and so I got more of the roundover effect. But if I raised it up just a little bit, like I said, I would have just broken the edge itself, and I would have gotten that same look as if we went through and just sanded it. But it's going to be consistent, and more importantly, there's no way in the world you're getting an owie off of this one. Well, maybe on the edge here, but you know what? We'll come back and fix that up a little bit. So like I said, all month long, the 1/8 inch roundover bit from Whiteside Machine Company is the router bit of the month here at Matt's Basement Workshop and at Woodcraft. So I will have links in the show notes if you're interested at all in picking one of these up, because perhaps, as we will find out right at the end of today's episode, who the lucky winner is. If it's not you, then, well, you know what? You still have a great opportunity to pick up this great router bit. And you know what? That little laminate trimmer. I'm thinking I might just not return that one to my friend. Doesn't look like he's using it. So anyways, though, maybe I just got myself a new tool. So anyways, though, like I said, I will have links in the show notes, and definitely go ahead and check that out. So once again, a huge thanks to the great folks over at Woodcraft and Whiteside Machine Company. And, of course, if you have any comments, questions, suggestions, maybe an idea for using this 1/8 inch roundover bit, you know how to get a hold of me, mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com, or you can stop by the website at mattsbasementworkshop.com. And, of course, when you stop by there, you'll see the new look of the site, which is still under a little construction, but we're almost there. I'm hoping to have everything absolutely ready by the beginning of February when we'll make the big change. And like I said, we got some changes, and I'm going to talk about that in another episode coming up. But anyways, though, I think what we're going to do next is we're going to go ahead and draw the lucky winner. And like I said, at the end of today's episode, I'm going to go ahead and post the winner's name, and hopefully it's you. Or, well, maybe you. And you definitely need to have a win this time. It's time for you. So anyways, though, I want to thank everybody for stopping by. And of course, if you haven't entered for the free swag, you know what? Drop me a line at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com. Or, you know what? I'm putting a form up at the new website. It'll make it that much easier for you to get your name entered. So anyways, though, I think that's pretty much going to do it. I think I'm going to take this. I'm going to play around with that little laminate trimmer just a little bit more. That was a lot of fun. So until the next time, straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.